Hi everyone, and welcome to another video in collaboration with Papermill Direct. Today we are going to be talking about card weights and sizes and paper. So this will help you to pick the right thickness, weight of card, paper, depending on what project you're doing. So you'll have seen when you're looking to buy your cardstock and stuff, that it in the UK it is listed as GSM, so there will be a 220 GSM, 300 GSM. So now we're going to talk about that. So what is GSM? GSM stands for grams per square meter. So that is the number of grams in the weight of one square meter sized sheet of paper. So it obviously a 220 GSM is going to be lighter weight than a 300 GSM, for example. So the higher the GSM, the heavier that 1 meter, 1 square meter of cardstock is, and therefore it's usually thicker. Not always, the actual thickness can depend on what materials and fibres have been used in the production of the paper, but in general, the higher the GSM, the heavier the paper, the thicker the paper slash cardstock is. So, which weight do you need? So, I have just pulled a load of stuff out of my stash. Haven't got every weight, but I've got a few. I will give you an example. A newspaper, normal everyday newspaper, the weight of that paper is probably 35 to 60 GSM. It's very thin, as you know. 35 to 60 GSM. Your normal office printer paper that I got from the supermarket, it's just cheap copy paper. Mine is actually 70 GSM. It says it on the packet. But for office printer paper, you can go 70, probably up to 100 if you are, if you're going on to the more better quality type of paper. So 70 to 100-ish is your office printer paper. 100 to 140. Haven't got any in that weight, but that is kind of a heavy paper, really lightweight cardstock. It is printable, so you could, if it's a lightweight cardstock, you should, depending on your printer model of course, be able to stick it through your printer and print sentiments or graphics or whatever you're doing on there. Most of the Papermill Direct paper stock falls within that, 100 GSMs or above range. So then we go on to the next kind of range, which is, let's say, 150 to 200 ish. So these are, that's why I took all these books out of my stash. You can see there, that one is 160 GSM. And the consistency, it's very pliable, it's very thin, but it's got some weight to it, but it wouldn't add a lot of weight onto your project. So that kind of thing, perfect for die cutting anything from, or doing matting layers and that kind of thing. So that's a 160. This one is a 150. It's slightly thinner. Can't really tell much difference, but similar kind of thing. Very flexible, lightweight, and it feels like paper. It doesn't feel like card. Same here. What's this one? 150. Same. So that is a heavyweight. 150, 200. Heavyweight paper or a lightweight card. So then we start getting into the card stock that we're going to be using generally in our card making. 200 to 230 to 240. That is what is a would be called, it's a thinner card stock. It is a card stock, but it's thinner and it's quite lightweight. And it's perfect again for die cutting, matting layers, all that kind of thing. So I think my buff here, just double check. Oh no, it's not. So these ones are actually, that's a 240 GSM. That also is perfect for a handmade card. Now, that's got enough substance to it that you could, you know, it's got a decent thickness. You could use it for making a card base. It would be okay for that. And perfect for die cutting, layering, etc. That's your 240 GSM. And now here is the, I've got a couple of different ones. So 200 to 230 is your thinner card stock for die cutting, matting layers and everything. 240, probably all the way up to 350 GSM, is where we're going to be kind of operating for handmade cards. Perfect for doing card blanks, invitations, whether it's a party, wedding or whatever. And die cutting, you can still use it for die cutting. But the heavier side of that range, 300 to 350-ish, that's the heaviest card stock that you'll get. It's kind of the thickness and the rigidity of a business card. So you can make business cards, you can make like really firm gift tags. It's got a lot less bend to it. So I'm going to show you that now. So here we've got two sheets of black. So this black here is just a plain black 240 GSM. It's okay. It's got, you know, it's got a decent thickness. It's got some bend to it. This black is a 300 GSM. You can hear the difference. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the difference. Maybe that way. Yeah, not really. But this one is, it's a lot stiffer. It's a lot stiffer and you can feel the difference in the weight. So a lot of card blanks will come in a 300 GSM weight. And if you are doing a special card that's going to have a lot of layers or a lot of embellishments on it or that kind of thing, it's advisable to go for a 300 GSM. So I'm very quickly just folding the 240 GSM and the 300 GSM just so you can see the difference in the rigidity for your card blanks. So we're going to be covering in another video, should you score or should you not score? In. So this is your, that is the 240. That's okay, it's still a nice sturdy card. And that's the 300. You probably, I don't know if you can see it, but no, you can't, not the way the light is. There is a noticeable difference if you stand them up like that and look at the leading edge. There is actually a noticeable difference in the thickness of the two cardstocks. You can actually see the difference with the naked eye, but I mean, as you can see there, that's a 240 GSM and that's a 300 GSM. Tell by the feel of it. And they're both pretty sturdy cards, but this one's a little bit on the wobbly side. That one is solid as a rock. It's not gonna, you know, if you've got a lot of heavy embellishments or other things to put on a card, then this with 300 GSM is the way to go. It's kind of the standard, if you like, for a card base, and it will support a lot of weight if you're doing a more complicated or heavy card. So get really technical for a minute here. For those of you who watch other channels, etc., and you'll no doubt see a lot of US designers. Now, in America, they use pounds for the weight of the cardstock. And so, you know, you're watching a program and the person, and a video, and then somebody saying, "Oh, right, I'm using some 80 pound paper or 110 pound paper or cardstock or whatever." How do you convert one to the other? It's a simple sum, but it's not a simple answer, as usual. Because the formula that you need to calculate the poundage to the GSM, to convert pounds to GSM, or in fact the other way around, is it will depend on what type of paper it is. So if it's what they would technically call text paper, which is a paper, the formula is different to if it's a cardstock, which is what they would call cover paper. So there are two formulas. So if it's text paper, which is a paper rather than a cardstock, simple formula, £1 equals 1.48 GSM. So an £80 paper would be 80 times 1.48, which gives you 118.4 GSM. Round that up, 120 GSM. So if you hear somebody saying, "I'm using an £80 paper," what you're looking at is about 120 GSM paper. If they are talking about an £80 cardstock, the number is different. So again, the formula is £1 equals 2.708 GSMs. That's if it's card rather than paper. So 80 times 2.708 equals 216.64 GSM. Round it up, 220 GSM. So when you hear people talking about my £80 cardstock, you're looking at something that's about 220 GSM. Just so that you know, if you want to do that calculation, because you've seen something that you'd like to kind of have a go at. And by reverse, if you want to convert GSM to pounds, you would divide the GSM by those two numbers that I've given you. So I'm going to put all that information, because it's a little bit too much to take in, I am going to put all that information in the box below, and in the information box below, and yeah, so that you've got it for future reference should you need it. All of the information will also be on my blog information below, as usual. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and I haven't bamboozled you too much with science. If you haven't already done so, please hit the like and subscribe button so you get notifications of future upcoming videos. It's been a pleasure as always. Bye for now.